20 red. Oh.
Get that. Go, go, go. Thank you. Ian would like to welcome to the Seattle Gathering
Center. Be here. Enjoy seeing athletes who are questioning an ache or pain. We enjoy screening them. We do free screens.
So, Rick, you guys, is it fair to say you guys, as a physical therapist, you're kind of like a detective? You kind of like break it down and figure out exactly what's wrong.
And physical therapists are trained to kind of differentially diagnose neck pain from true leg pain, utilize those clinical interpretations to properly treat a patient. We commonly get a response from people that say, hey, that's magic. And my favorite comment is, no, that's science. One of the things we have, and we'd like to introduce you to our AlterG treadmill, which is an anti-gravity treadmill. This anti-gravity treadmill is used to increase the ability for someone to continue to train full stride, even overtrain in bounding maneuvers to try to accelerate motor control of a run, say for instance, and at the same time we can lower the body's reaction forces by lifting this person off of gravity. So here's our anti-gravity treadmill. Step on there first and then in there. There we go. We'll zip him in. In this bladder, we have a very intelligent treadmill. So this treadmill is going to measure you three times. So just be heavy. Just let your feet just be on the treadmill. Funny. Okay, so normal running speed or normal walking speed is 2.5 miles an hour. So try to get that up to about 2.5. That'll be just a relatively normal walking speed. Okay, let's bring up to like 4.5 if that feels all right to you.
Wow, you really feel much lighter, makes you. That's great.
The gait mechanics, foot and ankle, hip and knee.
Yeah, you can really. I had an ankle injury once, and this would have really helped, I think.
This allows for freedom of arm movement, and it's highly specific, very easy to change that weight resistance.
And what speed are you running at, Josh?
Only 7 miles an hour right now.
It looks like a walk in the park.
There you have it.
So, Rick, what's the strangest injury you've seen here? I mean, you get like someone from the chess club or tennis, bowling. What's the strangest injury you treat here?
Are these wonderful roller derby girls.
Roller derby, there we go.
Who can't seem to avoid contact in their sport. It's just the most amazing thing. It's a real deal. And those gals, and those guys, when they get together, something gives. And what gives, well, is what we see in here.
Those are some tough gals. You don't want to mess with the roller derby.
It's a real deal. They're a real deal. They're real. They're great athletes. And they're really strong and highly motivated. And they get better really fast, and they're fun to work with.
We might have to cover roller derby. So, Rick, how would you recommend an athlete come get to where you are in the current healthcare environment today?
The current healthcare environment's changing fast, and one of the things that we are seeing is that the insurance companies are really mandating lots of levels of oversight, unfortunately. So, A lot of physicians that we work with are highly skilled in identifying the severity of your injury. And what physical therapists are very good at, and Seattle Heel Physical Therapy is also extremely good at, is helping to decipher severity of your injury and appropriate treatment. Most of the time what we do is make people work to get better. It's a real exciting thing for a lot of athletes that they have to work to get better, not rest, but work and learn how to work correctly.
Very good. Well, Rick, thank you very much for talking to us
today.
My pleasure. We appreciate it.
My pleasure. Thanks for coming.
Hello, everybody.
Hey, 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 hey future.
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.